What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Devin Payne. Welcome to the video, man. Hey, look, I know these stimmies are making their way into everyone's account. So with that, some people want to do something with their money. And for some of those people, that something is investing. So if you're not really sure of where to start or any good platforms to use, don't worry, I got you. Just be sure to stick around to the end of the video so you don't miss anything. You see, investing is one of the most effective ways of building wealth. I'm sure everyone watching this video has read an article of some sort talking about how much money you would have made had you invested in Amazon, Apple, Netflix, or Tesla 5 or 10 years ago. Yeah, we're not gonna talk about that. All I know is that after this video, you won't be able to use the
I just don't even know where to start
excuse anymore. I get it. When you're just starting out, investing can seem like this mysterious new world with all of these secrets that are only available to a select few. And for whatever reason, school did not teach us stuff like this, which is exactly why I make videos just like this one every week, helping to either supplement what you have learned or straight up teach you things that you wish that you would have learned in school regarding personal finance in general. But as to not waste any more of your time, let's get this video started. In the world that we live in today, virtually anyone can get started with investing with little to no barriers of entry. But before you get started, it's important that you're honest with yourself and evaluate your situation. Now, I emphasize this point because far too often, people think they can just completely emulate someone else's investing style and strategy. Before you start doing that, you need to ask yourself the following questions. The first question that you need to ask yourself is, do I have an emergency fund? This is important because if 2020 has showed us anything, is that you never really know what to expect. See, me personally, I don't like to have my emergency fund within the stock market because even if a fund is marketed as low risk, there's still some inherent risk associated with the fund. See, what I don't want to happen is for me to lose my job and I go to sleep angry at the world and then I wake up the next day, check my portfolio, and I've lost 20% of my emergency fund. Typically, you want to have between 3 and 6 months worth of expenses saved up for your emergency fund. Now, this is easier said than done, trust me. But if you don't have this, you can start off by saving 1 month worth of expenses and then just slowly building that over time. The second question that you need to ask yourself is, how old are you? Your age gives you an idea of how risky you can afford to be. Because generally speaking, if you're younger, you can afford to make riskier investments than if you were coming up on retirement. The idea behind this is that if you were to completely just blow all of your money on a bad investment early in your life at 22, then you have more time to recoup these losses later in your life. The third question that you need to be asking yourself is, are you interested in analytics and researching on a regular basis and reviewing earnings report? If this is you, then investing in individual stocks might be right up your alley. Later on in the video, we'll discuss a couple specific brokerage companies that you can start off using. Now, the fourth question that you need to be asking yourself is, are you interested in just a few specific companies and occasionally like to read and brush up on what they're up to and what's going on within the company? If that's the case, then mutual funds or ETFs might be for you. If you're unsure of the difference between the two, I'll leave a link down in the description to a video that I made discussing the difference between the two, so that way you can kind of get a better idea of the difference between them. Now, the fifth and final question that you need to be asking yourself is, do you have absolutely no interest in researching companies, but you understand that you need to do something to make your money grow? If that's the case, then you should just consider opening a high interest savings account or a certificate of deposit, also known as a CD. If you're unfamiliar with a certificate of deposit, it's similar to a savings account, except you deposit a lump sum of money into an untouchable savings account until its maturity date, which is usually a term of 6, 12, or 18 months. The upside of this is that you're usually offered incredibly high interest rates that you would not have seen if you just left your money in a regular savings account. Usually, the longer you lock the money in, the better the interest rates. Now, these interest rates, they do not fluctuate. I don't want you to just get turned off by the fact that I said it's locked in, because if you absolutely need the money, you can withdraw it, except if you withdraw it before its maturity date, then you'll incur an early withdrawal penalty. Okay, now once you've answered these questions, you're ready to move on to the next step, which is opening a brokerage account. Now, an online brokerage account is more than likely your quickest and easiest way to start investing. You're able to buy stocks, funds, or individual retirement accounts, or IRAs. Now, I won't get too deep into the difference between a Roth IRA and a traditional IRA, but I will make a video on it later if that's something that you guys are interested in. Just leave me a comment down below and let me know if that is something that you want to see. But anyway, when you're looking into brokerage accounts, realize that they're a dime a dozen. So it's really important that you're paying attention to the subtle differences like trading commissions.
Ew.
And account fees.
Gross.
If you prefer a more hands-off approach, you could utilize a robo-advisor. Now, robo-advisor is an automated service that builds your portfolio based on your interests and your goals. Because you're not speaking to a human, this usually costs less than 0.5% of the assets that are being managed. So there are a lot of brokerage companies out there, and that in and of itself can be overwhelming. So I'll just give you guys 5 to start out with. First, there's Robinhood. Robinhood is super easy to use, and they're one of the pioneers when it comes to commission-free trading. They polarized the world of brokerage accounts by offering these no-cost trades, which made it possible for virtually everyone to get started with investing. And that made other brokerage companies follow suit. They're actually doing a promotion right now where if you create and fund an account using my link below in the description, then you will get a free stock. Next up, we have Webull. Now, they boast $0 trade fees, no account minimums, and they're running a promotion where if you open up an account using my link below and fund it with $100 to be used for trading, then you will receive 4 free stocks. This offer changes from time to time, so if you want to take advantage of that, I advise you to sign up quickly and hurry up and fund that account. Now, in my opinion, they're not as user-friendly as Robinhood, but they give you 4 free stocks. And that was enough to pique my interest, so go on, get on it. Now, I lump these last 3 together. We have E-Trade, Fidelity, and Vanguard. Now, E-Trade is running a promotion as well, but that's a little bit more difficult to get. Like, you really have to earn this one. What I mean is that you have to fund your account with $5,000 to be eligible to receive a $50 cash credit, which I mean is better than nothing because Fidelity and Vanguard right now, they're not running any promotions. So I mean, it just ultimately depends on what you want. Now, don't say that to completely scare you away from Fidelity or Vanguard because I actually have accounts with both. I'm just saying you're not going to get anything free as of right now, but they've been around for a really long time. They're pretty easy to use, and they have some pretty good ETFs and mutual funds in there as well. So I recommend you check them out too. The next step in your investment journey is to set a budget. This is for obvious reasons, but realize that these stocks and these funds, they're all priced differently, and their prices are almost always changing. A lot of times you'll find that mutual funds have relatively high minimum investments. So if you're not really there and you can't afford it right now, then you can look into ETFs, which sometimes actually have no minimum investments. Either way, you'll need to take a look at your finances, and once your emergency fund is looking healthy, you've paid off your bills, and you have a little bit of money left over that you won't need in the short term, then go ahead and just transfer that over into the brokerage account. Now you've reached the most excitingly gut-wrenching part of this process, and that is buying stocks. Now there are so many mistakes that you can make when you're beginning your investing journey. So I've actually created a video outlining a couple of those mistakes that I'll link right here for you guys to check that out. Now, because I've already made a video on the topic, and they usually take so long to make, and I just put so much effort into it, I won't completely repeat everything that I said in the video, but I just want to really stress that you guys are only investing in companies that you understand. That way, you at least empower yourself with a sense of knowledge and understanding, so that way if something starts to look wrong within the company, or if something just doesn't make sense anymore, you can make a well-informed decision regarding your future investments in that company. Another tip is to stay away from very volatile stocks until your heart can handle it and you get the hang of investing. To me, guys, this is the fun part in investing, because as soon as you purchase these stocks, as soon as you buy into the market, these things get the moving. So it's exciting in a painful, masochistic kind of way, but nonetheless, it's still exciting. So guys, just make sure that you're having fun in this part of the process. So that's pretty much it for today. Like I said, in this day and age, virtually anyone can get started with investing. But with that, you can also mess up in a major way. So make sure that you're doing your own homework and only investing money that you are completely okay with losing, because you never know. If you made it this far into the video and you're not yet a subscriber, I hope I've earned it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Be easy.